Well, okay, I was not expecting this. Claude Haiku 4.5 just dropped out of nowhere. And honestly, that headline alone got me to close out of my other tabs and just sit up for a second. Because, yeah, Haiku's always been the fast one in Anthropic's lineup, the lightweight little sibling you throw at quick tasks, doc summaries, code snippets, or when you just want to move now. But this update, let's just say if you're building solo and you're used to treating AI agents like part of your actual workflow, not just a toy, not just another chatbot, this is the one you're going to want to pay attention to. And what's wild is Anthropic didn't just slap on a new version number. They're coming right out and saying Haiku 4.5 is the fastest, most cost-effective model for enterprise and large-scale workloads. So, yeah, I guess that means indie devs get the speed bump too. Let's get into what actually matters for solo devs, especially if you're running Claude Code, Codex, Cursor, all the usual suspects. I'm going to break down what changed, where it lands for real-world indie work, and honestly, whether this is just another speed race or if it's actually something you'll want to plug into your own workflow. Just real quick, I'm Daniel. Been living in the iOS trenches for what, 8 years now? Started off freelancing, working with clients, figuring out what actually works and what just burns you out. But after DubDub25, I kind of flipped the switch and went all in on solo dev life. Since then, I've shipped a bunch of my own apps, started putting everything out there in public, and honestly, these days, pretty much all my energy is going into Crafter's Lab. And yeah, it isn't just another tutorial site or another AI clone farm. This is my actual home base for solo devs who treat AI like a real teammate, not just a vending machine. And yeah, I'm in it literally every day. I'm building, tweaking, breaking stuff, just seeing what sticks, you know? And yeah, if you're part of the Patreon crew, huge thanks. And heads up, everything's moving over to crafterschlab.dev, and honestly, if you want to get in as an early member and lock in your price, now's kind of the sweet spot. So let's be real for a second. Faster gets thrown around all the time in the AI world. Usually it's just code for we tweaked the servers, or we'll let you send a few more requests before you hit your limits. But the way Anthropic lays it out, Haiku 4.5 isn't just shaving off milliseconds. They're literally calling it the fastest model, period. And I mean fastest at real stuff, reading, summarizing, digesting giant code bases, pumping out docs, cranking through multi-step agent chains, all that workflow glue that usually drags or gets rate limited if you're running something heavier. And I love this. They're showing benchmarks where Haiku 4.5 is pushing what 21,000 tokens per second for context ingestion. That's like reading 500 pages in a single second. If you've ever tried pasting a fat code base or an ugly log file into an agent, you know what a drag it can be. Now it's basically instant. But here's the sneaky bit I caught in the announcement. They're framing Haiku as the workhorse model for teams, but honestly, the indie solo crowd might be getting the best deal out of this. It's cost effective, which, let's be real, is a nice way of saying not gonna bankrupt you if you use it all day. And it's tuned for actual real world throughput, not just chat, not just playground demos. If your workflow, like mine, is all about jumping between ideas, reviewing big docs, chaining up agents to handle code review or CI jobs, you know how much of a bottleneck speed can be. Suddenly, you don't have to wait for a big model just to get reliable summarization or a smart take on your code. Haiku 4.5 is starting to feel less like the entry option and more like the actual backbone for anyone who wants to work fast and often. Let's get nerdy for a sec, because Anthropic does. They didn't just say it's faster. The post actually spells out that Haiku 4.5 is now more capable across the board, reasoning, coding, multi-step agents, the whole deal. So if you're the kind of dev who pipes log files, doc strings, or even product requirements into an agent and expects useful output, this version is tuned to want not just chew through the data, but do it without losing the thread. And yeah, they talk about enterprise workloads, but all those big features like context windows, up to 200,000 tokens, chain of thought reasoning, code understanding, that kind of thing, are exactly what you want as a solo dev too. Anthropic specifically calls out improved performance on real-world evals, the benchmarks that actually map to code quality, smart bug fixes, and doc comprehension. What does that mean for you and me? It means Haiku 4.5 isn't just the cheap model anymore. If you're using Claude Code, if you've set up agents to run batch jobs, audit your Swift code, review Figma to Swift UI handoffs, or just keep your solo project docs tidy, this is the model that can keep up without those weird, laggy moments where you wonder if it's even listening. The article gets super practical too. Haiku 4.5 is specifically tuned for agent use cases. That means all the indie workflows that look like multi-file analysis, plan generation, code review, PR summary, doc update. You can now run these loops with Haiku and not feel like you're waiting on a background task. And I love this bit. Anthropic says, it can quickly ingest and reason over massive data, not just code, but also PDFs, financial docs, customer chat logs. If you're indie hustle, ever touches client work, audits, or even just needs to brute force through a big requirements doc, and you can actually do it live with Haiku without shelling out for Sonnet or Opus just to not time out. So yeah, from the ground up, this update isn't about beating the big models at a single task. It's about making AI that you can throw into your daily indie dev grind and just trust it to keep up. And especially if you chain together agents or rely on a lot of automations. All right, here's where it gets personal. If you've been using Claude Code or Cursor for more than a few days, you know, fast isn't the whole story. Yeah, you want the agent to respond instantly, but if it's fast and dumb, that's just as bad as slow and smart, maybe worse. Anthropic's announcement actually addresses this. They're not just selling latency. They're selling a model that's optimized for multi-agent orchestration. That means you can spin up chains, parallel agents, custom tool integrations, and the model just keeps up without context drift, lag, or that, are you still there? Feeling that kills the flow for solo builders. And if you look close, you'll notice they're pitching Haiku 4.5 for production workloads, not just demos. So if you're building your own solo agent systems, whether it's code review bots, CI triggers, custom Slack tools, or even Notion integrations that rely on smart text analysis, you don't have to treat Haiku as the fallback. It's finally grown up. For me, what stands out most from this whole update is how it lowers the risk of building your workflow on an agent. If you're used to shipping solo, you know every tool you add is a risk. Pricing shifts, API downtime, context window edge cases, all of it. But with Haiku 4.5, you get speed, stability, and capability all in one. The model is basically saying, go ahead, build your daily workflow on me. I'll actually keep up. And in that last paragraph, Anthropic spells it out. Haiku 4.5 is available now in the API and in Claude Pro. That's huge. If you're already using Claude Pro and Cursor or running your own API keys and automation, you can just swap over and start running actual production code through it. You don't have to wait. You don't have to refactor anything. It's just there. All right, so if you're actually still here at this point, seriously, you're a legend. I don't say that lightly. I appreciate you sticking around, like for real. It means a ton. And honestly, if any of this even remotely resonated, just go check out crafterslab.dev. I built it to be packed with everything I wish I'd had when I started out, a Discord to stay accountable and actually see through the fog, plus a set of resources I'm honestly still building in real time. App blueprints, Figma foundations, growth insights, the works. But here's the thing, it's not just a resource dump. There's a Notion workspace in there with these dedicated team spaces. I actually use every day. There's the playbook, which is basically my live command center, where I plan out new apps, write docs, and share the real unfiltered process, not just the shiny marketing version. Then there's SwiftBrain. That's my deep dive Swift and Swift UI library, all the stuff I use to fine-tune, train, and power up my own AI workflows with Claude, Cursor, Codex. And Ops Lab, that's the new spot where I'm building and sharing all my AI agent systems, the Notion setups, automations, the glue that keeps my workflow together. Put all that together, and honestly, that's what I call Crafter OS. It's this evolving indie operating system for solo devs who actually treat AI like part of the team, not just a button you smash when you're stuck. And yeah, I'm still refining it, still experimenting, and honestly, that's half the fun. So if you want to get in as an early member and lock in your price, then now's kind of the sweet spot. Anyway, thanks for hanging out. If you vibe with this, or you're just sick of building alone, come be part of it. And if you've got questions, drop them below or DM me anywhere. I genuinely read every single one. So yeah, that's it for me. Keep crafting, keep experimenting, and don't let these tool shifts kill your flow. I'll catch you in the next one. Peace.